Let's learn how to do this. And this. And then change the bubble. And this. Let's explore the world. Even if you're not a coder. The first step to doing this is to go to funwithcomputervision.com. It's a website that looks like this. You will see a bunch of tutorials here. And then it says start building today. To have lifetime access to this is $10. And if you want lifetime access plus priority support, it's $99. If you're not a coder, I highly recommend this. By the way, I get zero affiliate income. I'm just doing this because I think it's really cool, especially for educational purposes. Once you purchase the actual access to the code, you will get an invite via email that looks like this. It took about 10 minutes to get this invite. Prior to that, I also received a receipt via Stripe. Once I click view invitation, I will then be taken to a page that looks like this. Now, if you have never used GitHub before, you may be prompted to create an account. It's free. All you need to do is use your email and then create a password, or you could actually log in with your email. Once you get to this page, you can scroll down here and then it says Fun with Computer Vision Tutorials. It then also has the instructions here. For me, I have a MacBook Pro. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click Command space, and then I'm going to search for terminal. If you have no idea how to get to this point, what I would do is I would go to ChatGPT and say, hey, I have this computer, this model, this year. What are the steps I need to take on my computer to clone this repository? And it should get you to a place where it looks like this. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to copy this and I'm going to come over here and I'm going to click paste and enter. Then, as you can see here, it will start cloning all of the stuff. And then what I'm going to do is copy this, and this will show the directory. And if I wanted to see a list of it, I could do ls. So you see that the files are here. Once you've cloned the repository and you see the list of files in the folder in your terminal, it's time to start having fun with computer vision. And as you can see here, there's several different types of projects. There's Hand Tracking 101, there's Shape Creator, 3D Editor, 3D Mode Playground, Arpeggiator, I hope I said that right, Handcrafted Shader, The Floor is Lava, Planet Explorer, Whirlpool Camera, what each of these projects actually does and the type of fun that you could have is in the description. So here it says basic computer vision setup with media pipe hand tracking. Make music with your hands and a drum machine, jump around your living room and dodge lava, so on and so forth. What each of these projects has inside are instructions to get to that actual project. But I'm going to show you a much easier way. As you could see here, to access this particular project, we would copy this, then we would click enter, add this, click enter, and then go to a local host. After about 2 hours of me ripping my hair out and trying to navigate each of the projects individually, it was actually much easier for me to access the list of projects inside of the localhost browser instead of navigating towards each individual project. And I'm going to teach you how to do this. The first step to do this is to copy this. Because instead of navigating towards the specific project, we're going to navigate towards the directory of the projects. Then you're going to go to your terminal and you're going to click enter. Then what you will do, the second step, is you will click Python MHTTP server. If you reach an error with this, it's okay. You'll see on the screen that there will be an error message. I'm only showing this because I want you to understand that if it happens to you, it's actually normal because the MacBook Pro actually comes with the Python 3, not Python. And so I'm going to click enter. I put Python MHTTP server, and then it says command not found. So the way that I knew to troubleshoot this is I literally just copied this. I went to ChatGPT, I pasted it, and then it identified. It looks like the Python command is not found in your system. This is because you have Python 3. But but the command Python is pointing to an older version. So I'm going to copy this, and then it will actually go to the proper one. Going back to terminal, I'm going to click paste and enter. And as you can see here, it says serving HTTP on port 8000. That's when we can go here, copy this, go to a new browser, and click paste. And here you will see the directory listing. This is where you could actually navigate the different projects and to start playing with them. So let's start with handcrafted shader. When you click one of these projects, you should show up on the screen. I got instructions from the founder that your hands should be a little bit apart from the camera. You should also address the instructions for each and every single one of these, which is going to be somewhere in one of the corners. As you can see here, it says fist 1 controls the frequency, fist 2 controls the amplitude, pinch to change shader plane size, and speak to change colors. So fist 1. So if I go lower, it's bigger. If I go higher, it's smaller. Fist 2. And I could say the color. Green. Blue. Red. Pretty cool. As you can see here, it didn't work with green because there is no green yet. To go back to the directory, you just have to click back on your browser, and then we'll start exploring more. This one is the 3D model playground. As you can see, there's this animation. The founder told me that you can customize this animation, which I think is really cool. But as you can see here, the instructions are say drag, rotate, scale, so it can activate based on your voice. Pinch fingers to control, drag, and drop a new 3D model onto the page to import it. To note, we also see drag, rotate, scale, and animate over here. And when we click animate, you can see all of the different modes that you could activate here. But first, drag. It works better when my hands are away from the camera a little bit. Scale. Rotate. Animate. And here it could dance, idle, jump, kick. That's pretty cool. RP grade. Here we go. Raise your hands to the roof. First, hand controls the arpeggio notes, pinch to change volume, move up and down to change the pitch. So it says, second hand controls the drums. Lift fingers to change the pattern. That's pretty cool. Next one, hand tracking. Again, this is the big, small, and then change the bubble. Look how cool. And how fast you move your hands is how fast it goes. That's cool. Planet Explorer. This is cool. So it says left hand pinch and move. And then up, down to zoom, right hand pinch and drag to rotate. So you can go like this. And then this is pinch and move. That's cool. Let's move the world. That's so cool. Let's explore the world. You get the point.